Okay, so we're boiling 4 cups of water with 1.5 cups of instant coffee, and we're gonna let that boil. Once it's boiled, we'll remove it from the heat. I have placed my oven at 295. I typically do 300, but for the safe side, 295. So this is an inexpensive cookie rack that I use for my lines and my grids. And this is an inexpensive cookie sheet from Dollar Tree that I use to do my paper dyeing, and I just specifically do that. I have a grungy little oven mitt that I use just for my paper dyeing because it is a messy job. And of course, a pan to pour my coffee into, and I will be putting my paper inside of it. So we'll let that boil, and then I will remove it from the heat. Okay, so now we're working on avocado dyeing. This is a small little avocado we purchased at Walmart. In Puerto Rico, we have huge ones. But a small one was enough for this project. And I'm just gonna remove the insides, and I'm gonna clean the skin. If you want, use the rest for avocado. Avocado or guacamole. Just clean it up really good, put it in a pot, and put it to boil. Now this is the coffee. As you can see, it's steaming hot, so we do not want to do anything with it while it is hot. So my avocado is boiling for about 20 minutes, and I'll let it boil, and you'll see the nice colors. Okay, so right now I am dipping my paper scraps into that mixture of coffee, and it has pretty much cooled down significantly, and now I'm placing it in my cookie sheets. Now these are just scraps, and they're perfect for little mini albums or little inserts on your pages. And you can see how rich the color is when you use that 1.5 cup of instant coffee. All right, those are the sheets for our journal. And I have my cookie rack right next to it. I'm dipping it in, front and back. You can see how rich that color is. You want to place it in the cookie rack in the direction of the line so that you can get those writing lines. And it does curl up, but you just have to play with it. And just place it on your sheet. And once your rack, you can take some splatters of the coffee and just splatter it on there to get more effects. And place it in the oven. It takes about 1 to 2 minutes for it to dry up. And here's me doing smaller versions of the leftover scraps. Okay, so the avocado dye has cooled down. I placed my laces inside. Those are the ones from the kit. And you can see immediately I'm starting to get some really nice colors there. So I like the way that turned out. Actually turned out really great. Yeah, I think they did real good. So that's my stash of paper, all the paper that I've been coffee dyeing. And I took some of the laces from the kit and I coffee dyed and baked it in the oven in a cookie sheet for a couple minutes, making sure that I did not set my house on fire. That's very important. And those are the music notes that were in your kit. I avocado one, the one on the left was avocado. After 20 minutes, this is what the laces look like. I thought it turned out pretty cool. Nice rich colors there. So again, do it while the avocado is cold, not hot. And those are the laces that I coffee dyed. They're perfectly beautiful. I may say so. I love the vintage look on those. Really do. It turned out great. And you can take some of the crochet trims or doilies, whatever you want, and place them on your paper while it's wet and put it in the oven, and it'll give a nice impression on your paper. Almost like a little thing. And that's the results you get from that crochet trim on your paper. I love the way it turned out. Great. And those are just splatters that I kind of did. You get really nice results. So these are the scraps again from the printer paper when we were cutting them. and I just kind of dip them in the coffee because I'm going to be using them for a mini album. Again, I'm just putting in some of the sheets from the kit, and I'll be splattering some of the coffee that's cold on top of my stove just to give it a nice splatter effect. As you can see on this one, I didn't fully cover it with coffee. I just kind of somewhat did a semi-dipping. But I think it overall turned out great. I love the effects that we got.